Hey guys, it's me Tanvi and welcome back to my channel. Summers are right on the top of our head, sun is too harsh and oh my god, it's freaking hot outside. So today I thought of doing this video on how you can protect your babies or toddlers or kids in summers. And in this video I'm going to discuss top 5 tips or facts on how to keep your babies cool. You might be aware of few or all of them, but we often tend to ignore it, and now because it's really important, so let's get into the video. First, we are going to talk on clothing. Clothes in summers are something very questionable because you don't want to overdress your baby or your toddler. So they cannot tell you that they are feeling that heat and they've become very cranky. So to avoid that, prefer loose fitted clothes, especially cotton clothes. So when you go out on shopping, you can check the tag that clearly mentions how much cotton and polyester percentage is there in that cloth. So always prefer 100% cotton clothing. Also include light color clothes, include more of whites in their wardrobe, because light color clothes absorb less heat compared to dark color clothes, and that helps them stay cool. Do not put your baby to sleep directly on the plastic sheet or the quick dry sheet, because they trap the heat and makes your baby sweat. So always put a cotton sheet before putting your baby to sleep, and that will help them stay cool and have a very good sleep. Also, I would request you guys to please give your babies a diaper free time during day. I personally feel that diapers is more comfort to us as moms compared to babies, because these diapers might be good at absorbing pee, but they make your baby sweat a lot. So please give them diaper free time, especially when you are indoors. Second is hydration and food. Summers are very dehydrating for us adults too, so it's important that we keep our babies hydrated all the time. And what best than water? Offer them more water more often, and that way you will keep them hydrated. So if your baby is younger than 6 months, give them breastfeed or formula, whatever they prefer, on demand. So that way they will be immune and hydrated all the time. And if your toddler hasn't started speaking yet, so it will be very tricky whether they are thirsty or not. So what you can do is buy a cool and bright color sipper or glass or mug, whatever you prefer, and keep it always in reach of your kid and in front of their eye, so that they can grab it or at least give you a signal when they are thirsty. So this works totally in my favor. This is what I do for my baby. Whenever he's thirsty, he picks up his sipper and brings it to me to open it, and that way he's hydrated on. Offer them more fruits. By fruits, I mean seasonal and local fruits of your country. The storage fruits does not have that much of nutrient value, so you should always give them seasonal fruits. So give them at least 2 servings of fruits in one day. That will keep them full nutrient wise and also up their water intake. Like watermelon is in the season, so that is high in water content. And moreover, it's mango season, so all kids love mangoes. So yeah, give them more fruits. Also, if you're traveling, prefer packing non-cooked food over cooked food, because cooked food gets spoiled easily as the temperature is very high outside. And make sure that you taste that food first before offering it to your baby, because you don't want to give spoiled food and then make your baby sick. So that's really important. Third is bath. As adults, we prefer bathing 2-3 times a day because of heat and sweat, and your little one is also going through the same, so let them have some fun in water, because bathing is a great way to keep them cool and have fun at the same time. And make sure that you are always there when he is in water. Do not leave your baby unattended even for 1 second in bathtub, because even a few inches of water can be life changing for baby. So make sure you're always there. And you can have fun with your baby, let him play with some bath toys, give him a nice bubble bath, and that will be really a cool time for you as well. Also make sure that the water is not very cold, and you do not bring your baby directly into an AC room after bath, because that way they can catch cold. And if your baby is taking multiple baths in a day, then you need not use soap every time. Only wash their hands with soap and that's enough, because using soap every time can make their skin dry. Also, I want to tell you here that you need to check on the massage oil that you're using. Some oils are heating in nature and are heavy, like the mustard oil. So you need to use some light oil in summers and make sure that you clean it properly from the folds of the skin, neck area, underarms. You have to clean it properly because it can clog the pores and can lead to rashes as well, which you obviously don't want. Fourth is peak hours. So you need to avoid stepping out with your baby in peak hours, that is 10 to 6. Now that the temperature has reached 46, 47, so I have made it 10 to 7. Few minutes of exposure in sunlight is enough for the babies to get heat stroke. And I would say if your baby is younger than 6 months, then it's a big no, do not take them outside during this time. And if there is a need or urgency to step out, then make sure that you apply a good sunscreen, you make them wear a hat, you take umbrella along, and make sure to carry their water bottle always, and make them wear cotton pajamas or lowers, prefer them over knickers, that way you can save them from direct sunlight. So if you are indoors, make sure that your AC temperature is not less than 24 or 25. That is the ideal temperature and is not too cold. Also make sure to turn on the fan, that will make the air circulate evenly and help babies breathe properly. Last but not the least, and is the most important, is when you are traveling, you should not leave your little one in car. I would tell you a fact here that I was shocked to hear. A car heats up by 19 degrees Celsius in just 10 minutes. So you can just imagine how the temperature rises in a car and to what extent. Even if the glasses are down, you cannot predict what the temperature inside is. And I tell you, a child is at a greater risk of heat stroke because their bodies heat up 3 to 5 times faster than an adult. And we often hear sad incidents of deaths wherein either the child was sleeping in the car or the parent forgot the child in the car. I mean, this is very sad and it should not happen to anyone. I literally pray for it, that it should not happen to anyone. So to avoid it, please do not leave your kid in the car even just for 1 minute. Now, after watching all this information, don't just get yourself locked indoors. Let your babies free, your kids enjoy in the summers, because summer is fun time and monsoon is arriving soon. So few rashes, few mosquito bites and few things here and there are totally worth it. And you as a parent are the best caretaker of your kid and you know what is good for your baby, your toddler. So I would say just keep this information in mind, implement in your life, and I'm sure your summers will be rocking. And I shall see you soon in my next video. But before I sign off, just hit on that like button, comment, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel. I shall see you soon. Till then, bye.